Hallelujah. Hallelujah. him.
Worship him. Bow down and worship.
Douglas. Worshippers in the house today? Is there anyone grateful today? Is there anyone thankful today? Is there anyone blessed today? If you fall in any of those categories, if you're breathing air today, you're blessed. Can we just stand on our feet and give God the praise, the glory, the honor that he is worthy of? Amen. Amen. Somebody needed that. And that somebody was me. God is good. And all the time, amen. Now, since we got our exercises on for this morning, it is good to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Can we just give a round of applause to our praise team for ushering the Spirit in? This is holy ground. At this time, we will have our responsive reading, which is communion. As we come to the Lord's table, let us come with a spirit of humility and repentance. Compassionate God, have mercy on us, we pray. Let us examine ourselves, our thoughts, our actions, our motives, and our attitude towards others. Help us to remember our responsibilities to our family and our neighbors, our stewardship to you, and the work you have given to our hands.
O living God, we stand in need of your grace, strength, and mercy.
As we eat this bread, which represents your body, which is the true and living bread, open our eyes to recognize the intimacy that you yearn to share with us. As we drink the cup which represents Christ's blood shed for us, we thank you for the new covenant. Love ye one another, which is written on our hearts. Let us rejoice because our names are written in heaven. May this Lord's Supper energize every area of our lives, enable us to transcend our circumstances, our inadequacies, and our enemies.
God receive us, touch and empower us, so that our lives will be renewed.
We praise you, O God, who make us your own people through the death and resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Altogether, abide in us, Savior and Redeemer. Fill us with the life-giving powers of your Spirit, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. We will have a choral selection followed by our video announcements.
Cairo. Here are your announcements for the week. Come join us for Bible study every Wednesday at 7 o'clock Eastern here in the main sanctuary. Bring a friend. King Church and Children's Church will take place on the second and third Sundays in April at 2 o'clock a.m. For the week. Come join us for Bible study every Wednesday at 7 o'clock p.m. here in the main sanctuary. Bring a friend. Teen Church and Children's Church will take place on the second and third Sundays in April at 10 o'clock a.m. Ages 3 through 4 will meet in the nursery. Ages 5 through 12 will meet upstairs, and ages 13 through 19 will meet next door in the Family Life Center. The quarterly member meeting will take place on Monday, April 8th at 7 o'clock p.m. here in the sanctuary. Shiloh's Trustee Ministry will meet on Saturday, April 13th at 10 o'clock a.m. in the Family Life Center. Save the date. Teen and Children's Church will host the Church on the Yard in front of the Family Life Center on Sunday, April 28th at 10 o'clock a.m. More details to come. Please join the prayer ministry on Wednesday nights at 6:30 p.m. in the choir room. For more information, please see Edwina Williams. Come and join the Sisters in Christ ministry on their nature walk on April 13th at Salem Baptist Church here in McDonough. The time, 8 o'clock a.m. For more information, please contact Monica Moorman. The Women's Ministry will sponsor a bullying workshop on Saturday, April 20th at 11 o'clock a.m. in the Family Life Center. For more information, come to their table in the Narthex or contact Sharon Smith. The deadline for announcements is Wednesday of each week. Please submit by email only to Melba Lee at mlee@shilohmcdonough.org by 12 noon. All announcements are subject to editing. Enjoy a super and spectacular Sunday and a wonderful week.
There's one other additional announcement. Right after church, over in the Education Center, they will be giving away food once again. You may not need anything, but if you know of someone that is in need, be a blessing to them. Because everyone is not where you are. So if you can be a blessing to someone. Amen. At this time, we would like to recognize our first-time guests. If this is your first time here at Shiloh Baptist Church, I ask that you may stand at this time so we can acknowledge you. Any first-time guests? Amen. Remain standing, please. And for those of you that are online, this is your first time, hit us up in the chat box. The ushers will bring you some pamphlets around. And we just want to say thank you for choosing to worship with Shiloh Baptist Church. We are not ashamed to give God the praise that he is worthy of. This ain't no dead church. Can I get a witness this morning? Amen. So on behalf of the leadership of Shiloh Baptist Church and Reverend Kelly, we just want to say thank you. And we ask that God will bless you abundantly for taking the time to come and worship him on today. Now, before you're seated, Shiloh, can we turn to our guests and just wave and say, hey.
Hey.
Say it like you mean it, hey.
Hey.
Say it like you mean it, hey, girl. Hey, boy, all right. Thank you, you may be seated. Let's give them a Shiloh round of applause, amen. Amen. Brother Chappelle, this is your birthday, correct? Stand up, please. Can we give our brother a round of applause because this is his birthday? Let's give him the flower while they still can smell them. Amen. Amen. Now we have come to the time where we can give back to God because God has given back to us. If there's anyone in the congregation that needs a tithe and envelope, look on the pew that's right in front of you. There should be envelopes there. God is good. As you prepare your gifts, let us please stand. There are four ways to give. Givelify, you have the online, and here in person. And also, you can mail your gifts to P.O. Box 2410. Also, there's a secure drop box in the back. Just realizing how good God is. Let us lift our gifts back into the giver. Most gracious God, our Father, as we lift these gifts back unto you, we acknowledge everything that we've ever had or ever will have comes from you. And Father God, we ask that those that are in charge of these funds, give them wisdom. Bless them, O Lord God, so that this church can meet the needs of this church family and the community. For it is in Jesus' name we pray this prayer of thanksgiving. Amen. Follow the directions of the ushers, please.
Oh,
had a chance to give our doxology. Can I be honest this morning? Can I be open?
Yes.
Bruh Fred, you got me feeling some kind of way this morning. I see we have a lead guitar player this morning. Nobody texts me, nobody emailed me asking me to do this. I can do that. But you know what? A lie doesn't care who tells it. It is good being blessed by the brothers and the sisters on this morning. Reverend Cummins will be leading us in our altar call. But before he comes, can we everybody point to Reverend Kelly? Repeat after me. Dear God,
bless your daughter,
that she may speak your word.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Whosoever will, let them come to the offering, please.
Yes.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
There is hope in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
There is salvation in the name of Jesus. That is healing in the name of Jesus. Only thing you have to do is just call on him.
Yes.
My wife told me this morning before I left, honey, this is an offer call, not about you, but for the people. But she don't realize what the Lord had done for me.
Yes.
The Lord had brought me through the battlefield of Vietnam. He had brought me through a brain aneurysm, and he had brought me through cancer. I have to praise him. I have to give him thanks, because God been mighty, mighty, mighty good to me. Maybe pray. Most Heavenly Father, maker and creator of all mankind. Father God, we come this morning with thanksgiving in our heart and praising on our lips. Lord, we come this morning just to say thank you. Father, we thank you for our laying down last night, and we thank you for our early rising this morning. Father, we even thank you for the activity of our limb. Father, we thank you for the blood that's still running warm in our vein. Father God, you've been so good. You've been so kind. You've been so merciful to us. Lord, you is a shepherd that walked in front of us. Lord, we want to thank you for your rod and your staff you have beside us. Lord, as I look behind me, I thank you for the goodness and mercy already behind me. Lord, I thank you for the angel above me. Lord, I thank you for being the solid rock beneath me. Lord, I thank you for the Holy Ghost that's within me. So, Lord, if I had 10,000 tongues, I won't be able to praise you enough. Lord, we actually remember the sick. Remember the prayers of mine. Remember those that say, pray for me. Lord God, that have power in your name. Lord, Solomon said, if my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then we hear from heaven and we'll heal our land. Lord, we ask you to heal our land today, Lord. Lord, you know what we stand in need of. But Lord, we just ask you. Lord, we just praise you. We just ask you to open the door that's been closed in our face. Lord, we stand at the door and we knock. You said in your word, if any man hear you knocking, the only thing they do is just open our heart and you will come in. So Lord, we just thank you. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we just glorify your name. Lord, your love for your people is so high that we can't get over it. Your love for your people is so wide that we can't get around it. Your love for your people is so low that we can't get under it. Lord, we just say we love you. Lord, we believe you. And Lord, we know that there's power in your name. Lord, we ask you to let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my saint and your redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Born on the tree,
died to save
you. pray with me. Heavenly Father, we come before you on today, thanking you, oh God, for being the living room, the living bread, and the living word. Thank you, oh God, for being who you are. God, we pray now that you will speak to us as we go into this moment of hearing a word from you. We release this moment to you, for it is in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. It is good to see each and every one of you on this Lord's Day. We want to say welcome to all of you, all of the visitors that are here with us on today, those who are worshiping with us for the first time. We do say welcome to you on today. I was sent an announcement this morning, a good news announcement, and that I want to share, that was asked to be shared with the body. Ariel Collins, one of Shiloh's youth, is participating at the Masters in Augusta today. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. The Masters will have its annual driver, chip, and putt competition. Ariel competed 6 months against other youth around the country and won a spot at this competition. Her age group is age 14 to 15, and they will start the competition around 11 o'clock today, and it will air on the Golf Channel beginning at 8. She is a female Tiger Woods, winning all over the United States, and we have been helping to sponsor her since she started playing golf. So let us remember her on today and maybe catch some highlights on this afternoon. This afternoon. Won't you turn in your Bibles to Joshua chapter 1. Joshua chapter 1. Joshua chapter 1. Today we're going to be looking at the first 5 verses of Joshua chapter 1. Joshua chapter 1. Begin reading there at verse 1. After the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' assistant, saying, "Moses, my servant, is dead. Now therefore arise, go over this Jordan, you and all this people, to the land which I am giving to them, the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot will tread upon, I have given you, as I said to Moses, from the wilderness and this Lebanon, as far as the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and to the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your territory. No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you nor forsake you." As we wrestle with this text on today, let us think on the thought, when one chapter ends, another one begins. When one chapter ends, another one begins. The book of Joshua is about one chapter ending, literally, and a new chapter beginning. The opening words of the book of Joshua describe a period of transition. It marks not only a change in leadership, but a change in purpose. The people would change from Moses' leadership to now Joshua's leadership. They will also change from wilderness wanderers to being promised land warriors. This change would not only be difficult for the people of Israel, but also for Joshua. Joshua would lead the children of Israel into possessing the promised land. But it would not be an easy task. However, Joshua and the children of Israel had the promise of God's presence and the promise of God's power. This text teaches us on today that individually and collectively, God wants to move us from where we are to where God wants us to be. This text teaches us on today that moving from where we are to where God wants us to be is easier said than done. But it can be done because we too have the promise of God's presence and the promise of God's power. Verse 1 of the text informs us that Moses is dead. The death of Moses was a heavy blow to the Israelites. He was the one who led them from the oppressive Egyptian captivity. When the people were discouraged and wanted to go back to Egypt, God used Moses to calm them down and to rally the people to fear not and stand still to see the salvation of the Lord. When the Israelites were thirsty, God used Moses to cause water to flow from a rock. When the Israelites were hungry, God answered Moses' prayer to rain down manna from heaven and even quail in the evenings. For almost 40 years, Moses had served the Israelites' leader and as their legislator. He alone spoke face to face with God on their behalf. But now Moses is dead. Here Israel is still in camp on the plains of Moab, east of the Jordan River, at the very edge of the Promised Land. For 30 days they had mourned the passing of Moses, their beloved leader. But now it was time to inherit the Promised Land. Although Moses had died, God certainly was not dead. Moses' chapter had ended, and Joshua is getting ready to turn the page to a brand new chapter. Joshua is God's newly anointed and appointed leader of the Israelites. Joshua had been commissioned by Moses before his death, and he was now being ordained by God. Joshua was commissioned to lead this new generation into a new challenge of entering and conquering the Promised Land. The first point that our text teaches us there in verse 2 of the text is to rise up and move forward. God continued his conversation with Joshua there in verse 2 of the text by reiterating that Moses, my servant, is dead. It is as if God says to Joshua, Joshua, grieve the loss of your leader, but don't grieve too long. Don't allow your grief to abandon your progress and to stop your mobility. So look at what God says there in verse 2 of the text. He says there, Moses, my servant, is dead. But now you, Joshua, you and all the people, prepare to cross over to the Jordan River. Joshua is turning the page for the next chapter in his life. God was entrusting Joshua with the daunting task of leading the people out of the old and into the new. God commissioned Joshua to achieve three things: lead the people into the land, defeat the enemy, and then claim the inheritance. So God told Joshua to arise and to go over this Jordan. Look at this now. There are two pivotal moments for the people of Israel between the book of Exodus and the book of Joshua. The first pivotal moment had already taken place under the leadership of Moses, and that was to get them out of Egypt. Now, the other one that is to take place happens under the leadership of Joshua, and that is to get them from the wilderness and into the Promised Land. Moses did what God wanted Moses to do, but the time had now come for the baton to be passed to Joshua so the nation could go even further, because Moses could not go where God wanted Joshua to go. In a real sense, Joshua was called to stand up and to follow God's plan, even when his faith wasn't sure. The facts said that he wasn't the right candidate, and his feelings did not cooperate. Let me poll the room on this morning and ask you the question, can you follow God's goal and plan for your life even when your faith is shaken? The facts are risky and your feelings are not on board. Well, let me encourage you as I encourage myself this morning that the facts are the facts, but God is still God. The word of God is still true. We walk by faith and not by sight. So by faith, obey God's word. By faith, step out of the boat and walk on water. By faith, take the risk and follow the leading of the Holy Spirit. We must not allow our faith to be shaken or stirred by what we see or what people say. Perhaps that's the reason why God allows some people, some things, and some moments to fade away from our lives, because they cannot go where God wants us to go. God wants his people to turn the page to the next chapter in their lives. God wants his people to rise up and to move forward. We must get out of the wilderness and head into the promised land of all that God has promised for us. We need to rise up from a defeated mindset, rise up from stinking thinking, rise up from sin and habits that so easily beset us. We need to rise up from wrong attitudes, wrong motives, and even distractions, because God cannot take us to the next level of promised land living with wilderness thinking. How many times has God placed in your spirit to move forward concerning a job, to move forward concerning a business opportunity, to move forward concerning a new level in your family or a new level in your life? And as you begin to move forward concerning that specific issue, you encounter roadblocks along the way, stumbling blocks along the way, or offenses that the enemy has put in the way to delay you, deter you, detain you, discourage you, or even to derail your process. And instead of you trusting in the one who gave you the ability to move forward, you suddenly get a case of the could've, should've, and would've's. But God tells us today, as God told Joshua, get ready to turn the page to the next chapter. Rise up and move forward and cross over your Jordan River. Look at verse 2 of the text again. God says to Joshua, look at what he says there. He says, Joshua, now you and all the people prepare to cross over the Jordan River to the land I am giving the children of Israel. The Hebrew people had been living now in the desert for over 40 years. It was rough and a difficult time. They could not relax. They were on the move, picking up their tents and going from place to place. They were surrounded by dangers on every side, but they had the promise of God that in this this new land, they would eat bread without scarcity. In this new land, they will sit under their own olive trees. In this new land, they will have brooks, fountains, and streams of water. This new land would be a rich land. This new land would be a pleasing land. This new land would be the promised land. This is the land that was given to Abraham hundreds of years before. And now Israel is at the moment where they are getting ready to take hold of this promised land. They are standing on the banks of the Jordan River, and they can look across and see the promised land. But Joshua and Israel had to get up from where they were and cross over the Jordan River and possess the promised land. They had to rise up and to go forward. They had to change their focus from the wilderness to the promised land. They had to change their focus from what was to what will be. They had to shift their focus from the right now to the not yet. Oh, Shiloh, just like Joshua and Israel, if we are going to turn the page to a new chapter in our lives, we too must change our focus. We must rise up and move forward. We must be focused on the next chapter and not be distracted by the failures, the regrets, or even the disappointments. Today is a new day. We must get up from where we are and trust God and move forward. Shift our focus from what was to the new possibilities that can be. Shift your focus to the greater things that God has for you, because greater things have yet to come and greater things are still to be done. Is there anybody here who can be honest enough with me and say, I need to turn the page? I need to let go of some things, some people, some mindsets, and some thoughts. Put your setbacks behind you and shift your focus. Turn the page, because God has great things in store for you. Not only are we to rise up and move forward, but the second point of our text is there in verse 3 of the text. We should step out by faith. Look at this now. Hear God's promise to Joshua there in verse 3 of the text. Look at what God says. Amazing, y'all. Blows my mind. God says to Joshua there in verse 3, I have given you every place where the sole of your feet treads. This is the promise of God's power. Over the centuries, God had to reaffirm this promise, from his first words to Abraham to his last words to Moses. God will take them over the Jordan and into enemy territory. He then would enable them to claim the territory for themselves, and the land that he promised them, he would give it to them. God would enable Joshua to cross the Jordan River and claim the land. Joshua was going to experience the fulfillment of the promise that God had made to Abraham. He would lead the people into the land that he only allowed Moses to see. God had already given them the land, but it was now their responsibility to step out on faith and to claim the land for themselves. Joshua and Israel had to turn the page for the next chapter. Oh, perhaps there is somebody here on this morning who, like the children of Israel, who, like Brother Joshua, and you are holding on to the promises of God. I believe there is somebody here here who is looking forward to experiencing and embracing the promises of God for your life. But what our text teaches us on today is that as we claim the promises of God, as we step out in faith, as we move forward to where God wants us to be, there will be bumps in the road ahead. There will be bruises along the way. There will be hurdles to jump over. There will be challenges in our path. But the good news on a Sunday morning is that we have the promise of God's power in us and with us. Oh, y'all, when you go home and begin to read the book of Joshua. Because, see, beginning with Joshua chapter 6 and continuing to Joshua chapter 13, Joshua and Israel had to fight to conquer and to maintain what God had promised them, because there were enemies standing in their way. There were nations and kings who were trying to keep them from what God had promised them. They had to deal with the walls of Jericho. They had to deal with the city of Ai. They had to deal with the five kings. They had to deal with the southern cities and the northern cities. They had to fight the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Hivites, the Perizzites, the Girgashites, the Amorites, and the Jebusites. God had given them the land, but they had to possess the land. And to possess the land, they had to fight for the land. But look at the text, y'all, because verse 3 already told them that God was going to give them every place that the sole of their foot walked on. See, what the enemy did not know is that it was a fence fight. So all Joshua and Israel had to do was to step out on faith. Oh, Shiloh, this text teaches us on today that as we claim the promises of God, as we step out in faith, as we move forward in the things of God, as we turn the page to the next chapter in our lives, we serve a God who can go before us and prepare the way for us. Because, see, whenever the Lord assigns a difficult task for your hands to do, then the Lord will give you what you need to carry it out. When God gives you a special work to do, it may frighten you, but I double dog dare you to do it afraid and do it scared, because God will see you through. We serve a God who goes ahead of us and prepare the way for us. So often, Shiloh, our biggest enemy is this person right here. Our biggest enemy to our hindrance is ourselves. We get in our own way because we would rather have the safety of the wilderness rather than the unknown of the promised land. So we get stuck on the banks of the Jordan River, and if we're not careful, as we stand on the Jordan River, we'll start drifting backwards to what is familiar. But the text challenges on today to step out in faith, to turn the page to the next chapter, and God will go before us to prepare the way. God knows that we'll have moments of feelings of inadequacy. God knows we'll have moments of weakness. God knows that we'll have moments of fear. God knows that we'll face some hard tasks and some difficult people. But God says to us to step out in faith, because I'm going to go before you. And every place that your feet stop, I will give it to you. God knows that there are giants in the land, but how many of you know that we serve a God who is still giants called fear. You may have giants called difficult people. You may have giants called lack of resources. But the good news on a Sunday morning is that God can handle your giants, because where God guides, God provides. When we do our part, what he can gamble. When we do our part, God will do his part. God has the power to go before us. We must have the courage to turn the page for the next chapter in our lives. We don't have all the answers. We don't know the who's, the what's, the why's, or the when's. We don't know the where's, but we do know God. And we have a history with God. And how many of you know that God has a track record? So if we trust in the all-knowing God, if we trust in the all-powerful God, if we trust in the ever-present God, God has a way of going before us to prepare the way. When we trust in God, God can turn our fear into faith. When we trust in God, God can make the impossible the reality. When we trust in God and lean not to our own understanding, God has a way of making our path straight. Is there anybody here who will say with me, I will trust in God? First point of the test is to rise up and move forward. The second point of the test is to step out by faith. The third point of the test, and then we're going to go and look at some baseball and some basketball. Verse 5 is that God is with us. Look at this now. Joshua was thrust into a position of great responsibility. No doubt the enormity of the challenge before him made him tremble in his boots. But Joshua had to turn the page to a new chapter. In Joshua's own strength, it would be impossible to lead the people of Israel from the wilderness into the promised land. But along with God's marching orders, God gave him a reassuring promise. God promised Joshua victory in the promised land. Look at verse 5 of the text. God says to Joshua there in verse 5, no one will be able to stand against you as long as you live. I will be with you. I will not leave you or forsake you. This is the promise of God's presence. Joshua and Israel would be unstoppable. God would enable Joshua to defeat the enemy. And God promised Joshua victory even before the battle start, which is why it was a fence fight. God promised Joshua victory over everybody and anybody who came up against them. The people who lived in the land were protected by powerful armies and fortified cities. The battles fought would be hard to fight, but the enemies did not know that it was a fence fight, because the word of God to Joshua in verse 5 is that no one will be able to stand against you. I will be with you. I will not leave you, nor will I forsake you. And I just believe that this is a word for somebody on today. It is a fence fight because God is with us. In the moment of crisis, our greatest danger is discouragement. We see the enemy lined up against us. We see the enemy standing in front of us, and we are scared to death, but we have the promise of God's presence. Come here, David, and help me make this point.
In 1 Samuel chapter 17, when David faced Goliath, David told Goliath and the Philistines that this battle belongs to the Lord. I don't know what Goliath you are facing on this morning. I don't know what Goliath you gotta go home to on today. I don't know what Goliath is waiting for you to show up next week. But let me encourage you on today is that it is a fixed fight because God is with you. I don't know what bad news you receive on this morning as you made your way to church. I don't know who texts you while you are in church or the email that might have popped up in your inbox on this morning. But let me encourage you that it is a fixed fight because God is with you. This text teaches us on today that God's people can turn the page to the next chapter in their lives because we have the assurance of God's presence. And the Bible says that if God be for us, who can be against us? Because God is with us, we can maintain courage through difficult times. Because God is with us, our strength is renewed through the crisis. We can mount up with wings as eagles. We can run and not be weary. We can walk and not faint. Because God is with us, we can stand on, we can rest on the promises of God. There may be some who seek to come against us, but God is with us. Trouble and crises may arise, but God is with us. The enemy may try to keep you down, but like a jack in the box, you pop right back up again because God is with us. The enemy may throw darts at you like you are a dartboard hanging on the wall, but God will let you survive. Are there any survivors in the house? Because God is with us, we can survive the attack of the enemy. Weapons will be formed, attacks will come our way, but God will let us withstand the attacks of the enemy because God is with us. Is there anybody here who can testify that God is with me? Is there anybody here who can testify that you know for yourself that some has come against you? You know for yourself that some tried to slow you down, but on today you are a living, breathing testimony that the God that we serve, he protected you. God secured you. God kept you. Because God is with us. And just like it was with Joshua in Israel, God knows that we're going to have to turn the page of our lives. And so as we move forward, as we step out in faith, as we stand on the promises of God, there will be bumps in the road ahead. There will be bruises along the way. There will be hurdles to jump over. There will be challenges in our path. There will be Jordan rivers to cross. There will be Jericho walls that must come down. There will be giants to face. But the good news on this Sunday morning is that the fight is fixed. And if you know the fight is fixed, all you have to do is just show up to the fight. If you know the fight is fixed, then you can keep on keeping on. You can keep standing. You can keep going. You can keep moving. You can keep smiling. You can keep believing God. You can keep lifting up holy hands unto God. You can keep praising God. You can keep shouting unto God with the voice of triumph because the fight is fixed. You may have to cry sometimes, but just wipe the tears from your eyes. You may fall down sometimes, but get up and pray. yourself off and keep on going, because the fight is fierce and God is with us. So be not dismayed. Whatever betide, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide. God will take care of you through every day, all the way. God will. Yes, he will. 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 God will take care of you. So the fight is fixed. Keep moving forward. Step out on faith and turn the page and watch God work. Is there anybody here that can say with me, I will trust God? Trust God, Shiloh. Turn the page and trust God, Shiloh. Trust God, Shiloh. Some trust in chariots, some trust in horses, but we will trust in the name of the Lord, because in his name is power, and he can do what no other power. Y'all, launch out into the deep, y'all. Do what he has called you to do, y'all. Trust God. Won't he will make a way? Won't he will make a way? Won't he will make a way? Rise up and move forward. I don't know what situation you're in, but what Joshua teaches us today is to rise up and move forward. Step out by faith. I like that, because he told them, I've already given you the land. You just got to step out by faith and claim it, because God is with us. God is with God's people. God is with God's people. Because God is with us, the fight, thank you, is fixed. The biggest way, when one chapter ends, another one begins. And the biggest way we can flip the page to a new chapter is by giving your life to Christ. You can flip all day long, but if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, then your flipping is in vain. But I invite you today to turn the page on a new chapter in your life. I invite you today to surrender your life. I invite you today to stop fighting against God, because you're not going to win. So what we have to do, the SAT word is acquiesce to what God wants to do. Surrender, yield your life to Christ. And the thing of it is, I don't know what your story is, When you give your life to Christ, all your problems will not go away. But it is true what our senior saint says, that he'll make your load lighter. Because he is a heavy load sharer and a burden bearer. So I offer you Jesus on today. I offer you Jesus who loves you in spite of. Jesus is not like us and love people because of. But Jesus loves us in spite of. And that is who I offer you on today. It doesn't matter what your story is. Jesus just wants you to come. Come to Jesus. And truly, he will make your life brand new. But not only do I offer you Jesus on today, I offer you Shiloh Baptist Church. If you are without a church home, if you're without a church family, then Shiloh is a mighty good place to let your anchor down. I offer you Shiloh on today as we open up God's doors to you and extend God's hand of discipleship to you. This is your moment to turn the page to a new chapter. Right here so that everybody can see you. Miss Oak, will you come and stand with me as well? Shiloh, we are grateful to God that God is still enlarging our territory. Amen. Amen. We are grateful to God to the sisters, Miss Frazier and Miss Garner. They are coming to unite with us. They say that they were recurring visitors and they decided to make it official. Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We thank God that you were recurring visitors, right? We thank God that He led you here. There was something here that God led you to, and we praise God for that. And we just say welcome to you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And Shiloh, we are delighted that we have a candidate for baptism. Hallelujah. My sister here, Miss Oak, comes from Savannah. She says she's been attending Shiloh since February, and she wanted to come out of the wilderness and come into this promised land. Amen, amen. So she has given her life to Christ, and she will be going down into the water. So we say welcome, Miss Oak. Welcome to you. And we praise God that you decided. Once again, this is important. I praise God for the leadership of His Holy Spirit, for leading you to Shiloh, for allowing you to come, as I said to the sisters, week after week after week. And I thank God for that, for impressing it upon your heart to unite with us. So we welcome you, Miss Oak. We welcome you, Miss Frazier and Miss Garner. We welcome you to the Shiloh Baptist Church. Amen, amen. You may be seated and they're gonna get more information from you. Amen, amen. We praise God for what God is doing. We praise God for what God is doing and how God is moving in the life of Shiloh. We approach this table on today remembering another Fitz fight, okay? Another Fitz fight because they thought they had Jesus on Calvary's cross, but they did not know that the battle was won even before Jesus got on the cross. So as we approach this table on today, we approach it remembering His awesome sacrifice, remembering the price that He paid, remembering what He did for us. Just for me is what the song says. He did it just for us. Won't you pray with me? Father God, we thank you for dying just for us. We thank you, oh God, for this moment in our experience where we can remember the price that you paid for us. So we ask you, oh God, that you would search us and try us in this moment. We ask, oh God, that you would look within, and when you find what should not be, move it out of the way, God, that we will not eat and drink unworthily. Have mercy on us, oh God. Forgive us, oh God. We ask that you would help us to remember your body that was broken and the blood that was shed for the forgiveness of our sins. God, we thank you for the awesome price. We thank you, oh God, for paying the price. For it is in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
overlooked anyone. Yes, we need one. Has anyone else been overlooked? On the night that our Savior shared his meal with his disciples, the Bible says that he took the bread that was on the table, he broke the bread, and he passed it to them, and he said, "This represents my body that will be shed for you." So as we remember on today, let us all eat together. Later in the meal, Jesus took the goblet and he passed it to his disciples. And he says, "This represents the fruit of the vine, my blood that will be shed for you, the blood of the New Testament." So as we remember on today, let us all drink together. Amen. Please do not forget about the food across the street. Also, we received news from our resident golfer that Ariel won her competition. Amen. Yeah, I know. Our resident golfer, that's why I said that. Amen. So that is good news. Won't y'all pray with me? Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you, oh God, for reminding us on today to turn the page. We thank you, God, for reminding us that when one chapter ends, another one begins. We thank you, God, for reminding us and challenging us to rise up and to move forward, to step out in faith, remembering that we are not in this by ourselves, but that your word is true, that you will never leave us, nor will you forsake us. So God, as we begin a brand new week, we ask to walk in that promise of your presence, to walk in the promise of your power. Keep us in your care as we go our separate ways. For it is in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Coming, Clark.